There's nothing better than eating my favorite cereal in the morning. Breakfast is the most important meal of the day, right? Well, it seems like that it is not only important what you eat, but also when you eat it. At least there are two forms of diets which claim that. These diets are called intermittent fasting and caloric restriction. I know there are many types of diets out there which claim to be beneficial because of this or that reason. And to be honest, I was a bit skeptical when I started to make a video about the science of diets. But my views on caloric restriction and intermittent fasting have changed. The scientific literature of both diets is astonishing. And besides obvious benefits of these two diets, such as losing weight or having a lower risk of developing heart diseases, they might also do something else. Intermittent fasting and caloric restriction might prolong our lives. So with that, I'm happy to share with you the science of intermittent fasting and caloric restriction. My name is Kim Steinig, and today we'll talk about two different forms of diets and how they might prolong our lives. Just as a short disclaimer, I've not started any form of diet. I also do not sell vitamins or anything like that. I'm just a young scientist who likes to read and do research. With that, let's begin. In order to find out how diet can slow down aging, we need to define aging. Of course, there are some obvious characteristics of elderly people. Our hair becomes white or we become bald, or sometimes both, depending on the genes we have inherited from our parents. Fingers crossed. We are also less mobile, our body becomes more fragile, and our cognitive abilities decline. Besides these notable changes, cells in our body also age. For example, as cells become older, they tend to accumulate more mutations, meaning they have more errors in their DNA. That of course can make our cells more vulnerable or in some cases lead to more mutations and the formation of cancer. Additionally, stem cells in our body also become less efficient. You see, stem cells have to constantly renew parts of our body and it doesn't work anymore as we age. This has especially implications for our guts or our immune system, as stem cells are highly active there. DNA sequences at the end of our chromosome, called telomeres, also diminish as we age, and we've already covered them in this video here. And our mitochondria also become dysfunctional. Mitochondria, of course, are the powerhouse of the cell. Yeah, I just had to say that and you will have to hear it again. If mitochondria are less intact, our cells can store less energy, and this of course sounds terrible. Of course, there are also other ways for which our cells can age, but these are some hallmarks which will be important later in this video. So we are successful in proving that a diet can prolong lives if A, the lifespan of humans or animals is directly increased, and B, at least one of the hallmarks of aging becomes better. Let's first talk about caloric restriction. We will define caloric restriction as a 20 to 40% reduction in average calorie intake. In other words, we supply our body with less nutrients and energy. There are many studies which have documented that caloric restriction prolongs the lives of different animals. This includes yeast, worms, flies, rodents, or primates. And yeah, even worms tend to live longer if we provide them with less nutrients. Mice, for example, which have been maintained on caloric restriction throughout their lives, tend to live 35 to 65% longer than control mice. These mice also have a later onset of different age-related diseases, such as heart diseases or cancer. Other studies have investigated the effects of caloric restriction on monkeys, which of course are very closely related to humans. Monkeys and humans share their eating and sleeping behavior and the way they age. So, two independent studies aim to investigate whether caloric restriction increases the lifespan of rhesus monkeys. And here we have some controversial data, as one study suggests that caloric restriction has a beneficial effect on the lifespan of monkeys, while the other study did not find any crucial significant effect. And if you go through the scientific literature, you will find that a lot of people have discussed these two studies and their outcomes. Right now, however, it seems like caloric restriction has beneficial effects on the survival of monkeys and the observed differences between the two studies are explainable due to differences in their experimental setup. So we have now talked about animals, so what about humans? Well, several studies aim to investigate what happens to overweight people if they start caloric restriction. As expected, these studies came to the conclusion that caloric restriction reduces the weight of overweight people and also improves cardiac risk factors and insulin sensitivity. But what about cellular aging? The same study has shown that we find less oxidative DNA damage in people with caloric restriction. This means that less mutations might occur. There are also some proteins which are normally reduced in aging cells and which start to accumulate if we undergo caloric restriction. AMPK, for example, is a protein which is normally very important to sense the energy available for a cell, and its production normally diminishes if we become older. Caloric restriction, however, has been shown to increase the levels of this protein in cells. This might indicate that cells regulate their energy uptake better. AMPK also regulates the production of other very important proteins, including sirtuins. Sirtuins are a very famous group of proteins when we talk about aging, and they regulate stress resistance in cells. So in other words, if we produce higher levels of sirtuins, then our cells might have a better chance of surviving. We've also said that mitochondria are more dysfunctional as we age. It has been shown that caloric restriction helps to maintain the intactness of mitochondria. This, of course, is great news for the energy supply of cells, and one group of cells, stem cells, might especially benefit from that. This might mean that stem cells might be active for longer periods of time, meaning that our body can self-renew way better when we age. These might be some of the reasons why caloric restriction benefits the survival and increases the lifespan of animals. Awesome, right? Besides talking about caloric restriction, I also wanted to discuss another very closely related form of diet: intermittent fasting. By now, most of you have probably heard of intermittent fasting. It's everywhere. There are different forms of intermittent fasting, but the theory is that fasting for a given set of hours per day or days per week might be beneficial. One variation of intermittent fasting, called alternate day fasting, has been shown to increase the lifespan of rats. To be more precise, it was shown that rats which were maintained on alternate day fasting lived twice as long compared to control mice. Yes, twice as long. In another study, it was found that old rats lived 30 to 40% longer if they started the same diet. Compared to control mice, alternate day fasting mice were also shown to have less cognitive decline, meaning their brains were more intact. In humans, we also know different benefits of intermittent fasting concerning weight loss, blood pressure, or insulin sensitivity. As you can imagine, intermittent fasting also helps to counteract the hallmarks of aging in cells. In response to intermittent fasting, cells start to repair the DNA more, meaning that we have less mutations. And of course, also mitochondria become more efficient, hashtag powerhouse of the cell. Similar to caloric restriction, intermittent fasting also benefits the production of sirtuins. You might remember sirtuins from earlier in this video. They are this very famous group of proteins which help cells to become more stress resistant. And last but not least, we also come to stem cells. As we've already discussed, stem cells become less and less active as we age. A recent study has evaluated the general effects of fasting on stem cells in mice. And indeed, it was found that in response to fasting, stem cells became more active in the gut of aged mice. This might support the idea that intermittent fasting has similar effects, but we need further confirmation to say that. What I want to point out, however, is that extreme forms of caloric restriction or fasting do not benefit us. It has been shown that malnutrition can be as detrimental as dietary excess. Besides the two extremes of excessive eating and starvation, however, we find caloric restriction and intermittent fasting. These two forms of dietary changes seem to slow down aging. So with that, I hope that you enjoyed this episode on the science of diets. To be honest, I thought it was awesome. So yeah, if you have any other ideas for a video or want to know something specifically, just let me know in the comment section. And also like this video, subscribe if you're new here, and hit the bell button in order to stay informed about the latest discoveries in life science. And with that, I'll see ya.